prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you, son of man, I have appointed watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, O wicked one, you shall surely die, and you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save your sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Amen, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The last couple of weeks have given us some interesting things to think about. If you were here last weekend, you might remember Father Danny's homily, if you were here for one of his masses, where he kind of talked about each of us has a cross and how we are called to carry the cross. And in some way, even though the cross can almost be unbearable, it's something that in some way we should welcome. Pretty challenging words. But that homily, I think, prepares us well today for today's readings. And today's readings kind of challenge us on what do we do when we see someone kind of not following the path that the Lord, we believe, has for them. Do we kind of ignore it? Or do we try to help bring that person up? In the words of that first reading from the prophet Ezekiel, you know, I have to admit, many years ago, I'm not going to say how many because it might be not that many, but I used to sit in a pew, and I'd hear that reading and think, woo-wee, thank goodness that's what God wants from the prophet, and not from me, because I'm not a prophet. And I guess that might be maybe the priests and deacons. They got a lot of answering to do when they stand in front of God, you know, but not me. But you know, as all of you Catholics out there know, you're going, my goodness, how in the world do you get good at being? Thinking who's not the prophet. You know, because if we, when we are baptized, we know that when you see that wonderful smelling chrism oil put on the head of the baby, that brings forth that we are anointed in some way as part of Christ's body here on earth. And as part of that anointing, we are called to be priest, prophet, and king. Priest through our prayers, prophet through spreading the good news of the gospel, and king by leading others with dignity towards God. So, I learned that somewhere along the way. So really and truly, today's gospel, or today's reading from Ezekiel, really is for us. It says, you know, God desires us to speak and bring folks to him when they kind of stray off the path that we should have. And when we see this reading from Ezekiel, we kind of might think that, my goodness, these are strong words and must be real bad and so on and so forth. But Ezekiel, like all the prophets, he's gone through this process at the beginning, folks have gone through all this sin. They've been terrible. They've been moving away from where the Lord wants them. And there's been a part that's where they've been condemned in some way. But this passage is actually from the part that starts with hope. Because what God is doing is, and with Ezekiel as well as with us, is we are the hope for those that may be slain. In the same way that Ezekiel is the hope for the Israelites and his nation who might be slain. So we are called in some way to help bring others back. And we can't ignore it when they are going away. You know, God's pretty direct in what he tells Ezekiel that he expects. So that can be a real cross. Because a lot of us love our family, love our friends, and we really don't want to get into anything that's going to potentially cause any kind of stress on them. But we also know that we want our friends and family to get where we want them to be with us in the heavenly kingdom. So Paul's letter today says, you know, we want to treat everyone like we want to be treated. So I think that kind of gives us some great guidance on how we bring a conversation with these folks if they need it. We make that conversation in a way that we might think, well, if I heard it this way, maybe I would at least listen. I wouldn't completely push them away. So that might be one thing that Paul is really trying to give us in the direction of. And we get a little bit better knowledge when we read the gospel today. And, you know, that gospel is really telling us, you know, probably what we do on Twitter today is not a great way to correct. You know, where you're going out and in front of a million people, you're saying, this person that said this is an idiot. And we should make fun of that person. Now, what Jesus is saying is we correct directly. And we don't try to embarrass the person. So again, these kind of help for us along the way can help guide us when we see the need to correct. And correction can be hard, especially in our culture today. You know, there's so many things that what we as Catholics know are true that some of the culture doesn't care much for. You know, chastity before marriage, sanctity of life, some of the things with how you treat people with dignity. All of these things kind of sometimes conflict with our culture. But we know that that's what God calls us to provide to each other and to help guide each other along that path. So we should not fear going into that. So I would leave you with maybe three things. One, God does expect us to do our part and ask us to do our part. And when we do it in a loving way. We're not judging. We're trying to bring these folks along the path that Jesus has for them. And we know that each person can make a decision, yes or no, on that. But we are there to just open their heart up, hopefully, where God can touch them and lead them along. And when we do this, we also have to remember it may be in God's time, not in ours. We might think our conversation is going to do something for that person, you know, the next 2 or 3 or 4 days.